When we receive files via WhatsApp, more often than not, we will like to be able to find those files in the future so we can play them or share them with somebody else. However, it's not possible to have a proper organization in order to find the one we want among hundreds or even thousands of other images, videos, audios, and other files. While it is possible to mark our messages as favorite, it's still complicated to identify one because there can be a huge number of favorites mixed with text messages. We can also get a list of media files, but only from a single contact. It takes several seconds to load, and we can't change the number of columns, find a file, or choose how to sort those files. Imagine it's possible to automatically classify those files according to their type, to add tags and then filter our files based on those tags, to sort them by date, size, file extensions, and other criteria. Or, with a couple of taps, being able to get a list of audio files received during a specific month. That's exactly what I will teach you to do using the application Gallery Droid. Gallery Droid lets us create any number of galleries. Each of those galleries have a set of rules which we can specify. And then the app shows us only the files that match those rules and keeps it always up to date. We will automatically create three or four WhatsApp galleries inside Gallery Droid, so all these files are self-organized and ready to be accessed. The first thing to do is find Gallery Droid in Google Play. I will also leave a link in the description. The first time you open it, you will need to grant permission so it can filter your files and show the ones you need. We will then be presented with a list of galleries that we can create with a single tap. This list will depend on the files you have and may take a few seconds to generate depending on your device and the number of files. Let's create our first three galleries by tapping WhatsApp Images, WhatsApp Videos, and WhatsApp Audio. You can also select Advanced Mode to create galleries with more complex conditions, but that's not in the scope of this video. I'm leaving in the description a link to another video covering that. Tap any of the galleries that you created, and you will see the list of your files. If the files are PDF documents, images, or videos, thumbnails will be automatically generated and shown. In this example, the files are voice messages, so no images can be shown. In this case, you will probably prefer to see more information about each file. Just go to Menu, Layout, or use a pinch to zoom gesture to reduce the number of columns to one. Because there's more space per file, you will be able to see other information such as the full file name and path, the file extension, its size and duration in minutes and seconds. If you type a file, you can open or play it with the integrated player. You can also swipe left or right to go to the next or previous files, or swipe up to see more information about the file and actions. Back on the initial list of files, tap and hold a file to select it. Then, with a single tap, you can mark them as favorite or share them using any other application. You can also add a tag to every selected file. Once a tag is created, it will appear on the top left. Just tap to see the list of files tagged with it. If you are looking for a file which you know is very short or very long, you can just change the sorting criterion. The same applies for file extension and seven other criteria. Now, let's suppose I'm looking for the audio message I received when I was abroad in October of 2019. A couple of taps let me find my file immediately. Then I can mark it with another tag so I can find it even faster in the future. If you know how a file is named, what its extension is, or the name of its folder, you can find the file by entering any of that information in the search bar. If you marked files in several galleries as favorite, you can use the automatically generated gallery favorite to find them all in a single place. Of course, you can sort those files the way you prefer and can use tags to further filter them. If you have Android 8 or newer, you can easily create shortcuts to any or all of your galleries. That way, you can access them and your files even faster. Well, that's all I have to share for today. I hope you found this video and app useful. Don't hesitate to leave any question, suggestion, or comment. Bye.